So I'm back. I only just did a live stream about, 20 minutes ago, and then I went for a walk outside, and I noticed an older man, spraying some poison, I'll call it, on the plants. So this is something that is, this is another agitation to me, is that we are dousing our planet, literally spraying our plants and animals and our Earth's surface with chemicals that are really bad. I mean, are there chemicals that are really good? I don't believe so, but with poison. So whether they're called weed killers or herbicides or fungicides or pesticides, whatever it is designed to kill. And I'm not an expert at it, but what I do know is the current research and what's coming out in the news with the chemical glyphosate that is made, that's in the product Roundup and other products as well, is linked to cancer, absolutely, unequivocally. And I believe actually that probably most, if not all, of the chemicals that we use to for the purpose of killing things are probably not good for us. I think we can pretty much assume that they are going to cause some kind of illness. And here's the thing, when you spray a chemical on your lawn, on your whatever you call weeds, on your shrubbery, on your land, it doesn't like just stick there. It actually gets washed into the waterways as soon as it rains or as soon as your sprinklers come on, and it rehydrates that chemical. And then we have it in our waterways and in our water supply and in the water supply that's for, you know, in our streams and our lakes and our rivers and our oceans, etc. It makes its way back to us is the whole point. So in my neighborhood, everybody sprays pesticides, herbicides, weed killer, and they always have these, they pay their lawn companies to do this. So the lawn companies are required, I believe by law, to put out a little sign that says, keep off until dry. Like that's gonna help anything. And so there's signs all over the place all the time because people get this done at least on a monthly basis on their lawns. These poisons are sprayed. And it makes me crazy. I walk my dogs in neighborhoods. I don't know which lawn I can let them walk on and which ones I can't. How am I supposed to know if the lawn is dry? Am I supposed to reach down and feel it? That would kind of defeat the purpose of staying away from these toxins. So I have a beef with this. I have a real beef with how much we are using chemical poisons on our planet. And so I'm on a walk and I see this older man spraying chemicals on the plants. And when I have seen this in the past, it's been the idea of establishing and creating a conversation with the person is so unnerving to me. It's just so potentially awkward and uncomfortable that I usually opt out. Sometimes I opt in, but usually I opt out. And then I get upset with myself for not having the courage to have talked about something that, yeah, might be awkward, but is actually a really important topic to me. So I got up the guts and I said to this man who was wearing shorts, I said, be very careful not to get that product on your skin at all. A lot of these things are known to be cancer causing and you want to be really careful. And he said, oh yeah, no, this one is safe. I read the label and it said that it was okay. It kills, it's okay for the grass, but it kills the weeds. Well, I said to him, I'm glad that you read the label. I said, I hope that we could trust what's written on these labels. The truth is they write on the labels whatever they can get away with to make the sale. It's not that they write on the labels the God's honest truth of what the product actually does or what the harm can be. And a lot of times they don't even know what the harm is because they haven't done long-term studies to establish what's at risk here and what kind of harm is being caused and created for living beings, such as ourselves and all the beings that we share the planet with. So I didn't want to put him off and I didn't want to turn him off to the conversation and I didn't want to make it super uncomfortable and I didn't want to make an enemy. I wanted to just have an open conversation about something that might make him think. Because when we start thinking more critically about our behaviors and our actions, then that's the place from which we can make some changes. So he said, yeah, no, it's safe. I feel like it's safe. I read the label and it says it's safe. And I said, okay, well, just, you know, be careful. I said, it's a toxin, it's a poison. These things do make their way into our water ways in our water supply, and they don't put that on the label, generally speaking. So I said, you know, have a good day. And he's like, well, I think it's just really important to read the labels. I said, I agree. It's so important to read the labels and to do your research. And then I wished him a good day and I kept walking. And I'm just saying all this to celebrate myself for having the courage to have that awkward conversation. I also think I did a pretty decent job of maybe introducing one more aspect to what he might do going forward, which is not just to trust what a label says about a product, but to actually do your own research. Look up the chemical names, see what research there is out there on them, see what's in the news. Because if people knew that using Roundup or products with glyphosate in it was causing cancer, is linked absolutely to cancer, then would they be buying the product? I hope not. I think when we know better, we do better. That's what Maya Angelou says, and I believe it. So have the awkward conversations. Trust yourself to know that you'll be able to handle them in the moment. I'm saying this for you just as much as I am for myself. And let's make a difference on the planet.